a ferocious afternoon out on track here at this amazing venue of Spa. Lewis, it seemed to me that you had this race under control from qualifying yesterday with those two outstanding laps, but you had a bit of nursing to do towards the end.
Yeah, it wasn't the easiest of races. There was a couple of I had a look up into turn five, which started to give a bit of a vibration, and then one into the last corner. I think just the tire temperatures were slowly dropping, no matter how much you're pushing. I guess as you lose rubber, you start to lose the temperature in the tires. So it was a bit of a struggle, but nonetheless, I think it was okay. I was a little bit nervous that we might have a scenario like Silverstone with that right front towards the end. So yes, I was nursing it. It looks like the tires got plenty of rubber on it, so maybe it was just fine and just all worry for nothing.
You're unstoppable at the moment. Your 89th victory, just two behind the great Michael Schumacher now. Your fourth victory here, matching Jim Clark. I mean, there's no end to this success. You're just on a roll.
I think, I know it's not necessarily what everyone always wants to see the Mercedes at the front, but you know, no matter how much success we have, we just keep our heads down. You know, when I go back into the office now, there's no guys celebrating. They're like, okay, how can we win the next race? And it's an incredible mentality to work around, an environment to work around. And the guys continue to, we're continuing to learn about us, about ourselves, about the car, how we develop and improve weekend in, weekend out. And honestly, I think it's crazy to think I'm 35 going towards 36, but I feel better than ever. So that's a positive. So I'm really, really grateful to the team, everyone back at the factory. Thank you for their continued support.
At the start, you won the drag race up to turn five at the top of the hill. Could you just relax a little bit then?
Yeah, I mean, that's it's a nightmare, that start, because no matter how good, one of the shortest starts to the turn one. And if you saw out of turn one, I had a big snap trying to get on the gas to get the gap. And even if I didn't have that, I would have had a car length, but he would have eaten that up the straight. So it actually worked to my benefit, to be honest, with that snap, because it meant he was on my right, up my chuff. I'm sure he had to lift. And then that meant when we got to the top of the hill, I don't know if he had to lift or what, but didn't have enough time to slingshot. No shake and bake today, so okay. I'm grateful for that.
Okay, congratulations.
Thank
again.
You.
On to Valtteri Bottas. P2 today, Valtteri. Tell us about your race. There was a point early on when you were saying, let me have a go, let me use my power up and have a run at Lewis.
Yeah, of course at the start, it would have been a good opportunity, but I think Lewis played it pretty well, that he wasn't too fast out of turn one, so I couldn't really get momentum to get him. And also today there was tailwind into turn five, so a bit less of a tow effect. Same thing in the restart, I just couldn't catch him on the straight, so I think those were the main opportunities. And otherwise, with the same car and Lewis driving also pretty much mistake-free, it was tricky, but I tried.
You made me smile when you said on the radio, I didn't hear that instruction that we're not allowed to race each other.
Yeah, I had no clue about that. Maybe they said it, but I don't recall.
Good stuff. Well, more world championship points, but what can you take away from this weekend? We go straight into Monza, of course.
Well, I think Lewis was faultless today and yesterday. He was quick. He earned more points this weekend. At least it was a clean weekend for me, no big issues, but definitely won those race wins. And, I'm just happy that there's an opportunity next weekend again.
Thanks. Congratulations again. Max, 33. You keep finishing P3. You could see the Mercedes at the end of the race again. A bit tantalizingly frustrating or satisfied with the day?
No, it was pretty boring, to be honest, not really interesting, not much to do. I couldn't really keep up with them when they were pushing. And then, from my side, I ran out of tires at the end. So the last, eight laps, I was just backing it out, saving the front tires. So it was not really enjoyable out there today. On the medium, I didn't really have a lot of grip. And then on the hard tire, initially I was trying to put a bit of pressure on Valtteri, but then they told him to speed up, and I couldn't keep up, so bit lonely.
Yeah, I can imagine for you there was some really good action through the field, I must say, but I wonder if you might come in to before the end and put some pressure on Mercedes, take some fresh tyres, try and get a world championship point. But Daniel Ricciardo was really annoyingly for you in your pit stop window, wasn't he?
Yeah, and I was not sure with their top speed if it would be easy to pass. So I was like, we'll just stay out. I think I was very close to a puncture, but yeah, we finished P3. I mean, more than that was anyway not possible today. Okay, maybe it was not the most satisfying P3, but yeah, it's still better than nothing, so I'm pretty set up. Yeah,
it was probably a good choice because Daniel did the fastest lap of the race on the last lap, on the 44th lap, so he got some speed.
Yeah, well, we just had no tyres left, so I was not taking any risks. It was probably a good weekend for them, and we just maximised what we could.
Straight on to Monza, looking forward to that.
Yeah, we'll try again, see where we end up.
Thank you. Don't miss next weekend at Monza, followed closely by Mugello, of course.